All right, so today I'm just going to really talk about the states and abolishing the states and the reason why. Right now, the states are all locked into their own little countries, essentially, where they're making their own rules and they're saying, we can have guns over here and we can have guns over there and then we can have over here. We decided marijuana and over there we decided no marijuana. So you're having all of these ridiculous little rules that have been going on for just a long, long time, and the making of those rules. So to abolish that structure and say, hey, you can't make rules anymore. We're just going to go federal. We're gonna just be like the UK. We're just tired of it. We're tired of the excess spending, because it really is. If you're running a company, you would never say, hey, I want to have 50 different facets, and they're all going to make their own little rules, and then we'll meet again later from all of the rules that they've made, and then we'll try to make another rule out of those rules. Because that to me is ludicrous. All it is become a big slow swamp that is never ever going to materialize with action fast. There's no fast action happening from the government. And that's one of the main reasons, is because we have the state bloat bureaucracy. Now, a state itself really needs to be simply a budgeteer, a budget system that is sitting there going, wait, wait, give me the money, because I have this many people, and you allocate the money to me. Okay, so if you look back in history, okay, you can look at the clans of Scotland, for example. So you have the clans. And they each one, this is mine, or I'm the laird of this, and these are my rules and my regulations, and this is our speed limit, and this is all of the dumb rules that they create. Okay? Yeah. So this is all this is, a bunch of clans right now making up their own little rules. Well, at some point, that's just it. We're in this modern age, yes, modern. We have no choice but to say, hey, that's antiquated. We don't need that. We don't require that. That's excess. We can just completely get rid of all of the garbage. We can still have the vote for all of those things, but it'll just be one unity vote for the whole United States. Okay, so when we're looking at what the states need, though, okay, so you're saying, oh, but they have this many people, and they over there they have that many people. Well, that's fine, that's great. So you keep them with all the, you can still contain them as a budget system, like, okay, you're going to allocate money specifically for the trees that you're going to plant for the climate in this region, okay? And that's it. And that's all the state would have authority of doing, would be doling out the money, making sure the money went direct to those cities. And the state is shouldn't even be needed in that respect. The state shouldn't even be required. It shouldn't even be on the board as a player. It should be doled out directly to the cities. But for some reason, I'm still going to be nice here for a moment in this. So this is all about this, what do they call them, the House of Representative group. Yeah, I don't think they're representing much of anything except becoming a hindrance. It's almost like that part of the Constitution just needs to be rewritten, and look at other parliamentary systems directly. They're fine. They've worked well for years. All of this, oh, America, just cram it. America is not great. America is like impoverished. It's on the verge of bankruptcy. No, America is not great. So the system right now, we're looking at 1 or 2 or 3 months possibly to just say, well, it didn't work. Government fail. That's how close we are to bankruptcy, to severe bankruptcy. So when we are have on the edge of this precipice, And yet you still have the bloat of this branch and this clan over here and that clan over there making their decisions. You know, it's wrong. So you got to get rid of those. You can still use the okay, fine, you're a representative, and yeah, we still voted you because you're in our jurisdiction. You can still use that voting system if that makes you happy, but they're not going to be the ones that say, hey, I'm the one I take it back. They're still going to be the ones that say, hey, I demand this or I demand that in the vote. They can still be used in that structure of voting. So take that back. It's just the fact that they're not going to be the state vote. You know, the state has decided this vote. They're going to just be the single house person, that representative or whatever, that senator, and they'll march in there and they'll say, well, this is my vote. And they're going to bypass the state, the state ordinance moment. They won't need it. They don't have to go there and all hold hands and say, okay, we voted on marijuana in our state, all of our houses of representatives. They don't have to do that. They're instead going to be free individual each, and they're going to walk into federal, and they're going to say, and this is my vote. And that guy over there is going to say, and this is my vote. And this one in here says, that's my vote. And they're not going to do the hand-holdy vote a collection that later gets sent off again. Okay, so all slowdowns. It's all slowdowns. We don't have time. We have penguins that are not even returning to their chicks because it was too damn hot. You know, we don't have time for the states to lallygag over this garbage. We're looking next at just a budget system, where the state itself is simply allocated a budget. That is all you get, and it goes here, 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 and here, and that should already be predetermined at the federal level. There is no reason why it would not be predetermined. I mean, there were all the same people. We're all human beings. Oh my gosh, all of a sudden, oh, they're getting awfully dark over there in Alabama. Maybe we don't want to give them too much. You know, maybe they're getting a little too liberal over there. We don't want to give them too much. Yeah, so we're having all of this going on. No, we don't want any of that. It's not a time for that. It's just population. Here's federal, and it doles out money to population. That's all it is. So it's a population accountant system that the state is there saying, hey, I'm accountant. I'm the state accountant. That's it. And I dole out to this city and that city and that city. But even in retrospect, that is not required and shouldn't be required. It should just be go straight city, 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 all the way across the board from federal. It's more lallygag in the middle. I don't know. It's great. I'm really happy for it, the forefathers, that they came up with the idea, but it needs to be rewritten. You know, just because something is hey, they made it happen, you know, let's just keep following along like a bunch of puppets and walk into the inferno of hell because they wrote it 200 or 250 or 300 years ago. Let's just keep doing that. Anyway, that's enough for today. I think you got my point. Just get rid of the bastards and make them only for the budget. If you have to keep holding hands with them. Speed limit, same across the whole United States. How about that? Highway speed limit, the same. You know, that. Can you imagine how much waste is spent just on that stupid number? 65 here, 55 here, 75 over there. You know, how much waste? I mean, it's disgusting when you think about it. It's just disgusting. It's a disgusting bureaucracy that has to be modified.